So last week, we announced a bunch of new features and improvements to the Lightroom Cloud ecosystem, as well as to Lightroom Classic and Adobe Camera Raw. Now, I already shared videos covering what's new in Lightroom Desktop version 8.3 and Lightroom Mobile 10.3. And in this video, I'm going to bring it on home by sharing everything that's new in Lightroom Web. Now, if you've been a follower of this channel, you know how much I love Lightroom Web and want to sing its praises because it truly is a powerful photo management and editing surface that you can access from a web browser anywhere in the world with an internet connection. That sort of flexibility is handy for numerous reasons, especially because you can access your entire cloud library and almost all of Lightroom's powerful editing tools right within a browser tab. And what's interesting about this particular update to Lightroom Web is that it gets new features that were added to both Lightroom Desktop and Lightroom Mobile, further illustrating how powerful this surface is. But instead of me telling you about it, I'll show it to you in action. Let's dive in. All right, so here we are in Lightroom Web, and you can see this is a web browser tab. I'm using Google Chrome, but I also use Safari, and it works great there too. And to access Lightroom Web, you would just go to lightroom.adobe.com and log in with your Adobe ID. So here I am in my account, and the first feature that I want to talk to you about is landscape masking. So if you think about landscape photos, most of them have certain common attributes, and it doesn't just have to be landscape photos, but when thinking about them, most of them usually have some sort of a sky. Maybe there's some vegetation, you know, trees or grass. There might be mountains. There's a surface, whether the surface is man-made or it's natural. There could be water. And so with landscape masking, what will happen is you can now use the power of AI to quickly create segmentation masks and just start editing individual localized components without having to jump through any hoops. Let me show you what I mean. So when I've been showing this feature, I've always started with this really poorly generated image. The reason why is because it'll let me illustrate all of the different segments that we can detect with landscape masking. So in Lightroom Web, the first thing we'll do is we will go to the masking panel here, and then you'll see there is this new mask here called landscape. I'm just going to click on it, and then Lightroom will start detecting the different attributes that are visible in the image. And when it's done, you'll see that this image allows me to generate all of the possible attributes that we have in landscape masking. So there's sky, mountains, architecture, vegetation, water, natural ground, and artificial ground. But let me actually work on an image that I took, like an actual landscape photo. This one over here, taken in Norway. Just like before, I'm going to click on masking, and then I'm going to click on landscape, and you can see that Lightroom has identified four attributes. And when I hover over them, you'll see an overlay. So there's sky, mountains, architecture, and water, which is great. I want to edit each of these. So I'm going to select all four of them, and here's what's important. You'll want to select this option to create separate masks. Otherwise, it would create one mask with all of these attributes. So I'm going to go ahead and click on create, and you'll see we have the four masks. So here's water, there's architecture, mountains, and sky. And so if I want to start with sky, I'll go down here. Usually with sky, I like to add a little bit of a dehaze here. I'm also going to add a little bit of a saturation boost. And I might actually drop the exposure just a tiny bit. Cool. That's looking good there. Now I'm going to move up to mountains. So with mountains, I'm going to add contrast, and I definitely want to add some texture and some clarity just to bring out some of that really nice rich detail. I might also drop the shadows to further add some contrast there. And I'm also going to warm it up with the temperature slider and add some saturation. Now I'll move up to architecture, which is this structure here. I'm going to open the exposure for that. You can see it gets nice and bright. I'm also going to warm it up and add saturation. And I'm going to add some texture. The nice thing is that I can apply, even though I'm using mostly the same sliders, I can apply them separately for each individual attribute, which is the power of masking and localized editing. I'm also going to add dehaze specifically to this structure here. And then lastly, we'll go up here for the water. And for the water, same thing. I'm definitely going to add dehaze. I really like what dehaze does to water. I'm going to cool that off a bit. And I'm going to increase the exposure and the contrast. And so now you can see each of these different masks were edited. We didn't have to do anything in terms of the selection. The landscape mask took care of that. And now if we toggle, this is our original photo. Let me actually go here to edit so we don't have the overlay. Here's the original. I mean, it's really great. And if I wasn't actually walking you through my editing workflow, this would be done in 10 seconds. But I just love the results that masking brought here. And so hopefully now you can see the power of landscape masking, that it can speed up the selection of individual attributes in your landscape photo that you might want to edit selectively. And it doesn't have to be just landscape. Like, you can try using the landscape mask in all sorts of different types of genres for photos. So you can try cityscapes, you can try anything pretty much outdoor will probably have some attributes selected. So just experiment with it, have some fun with it, but I want to move on to the next feature. All right, the second feature update to Lightroom Web is the improvement for portrait editing when it comes to quick actions. So quick actions were released in October of 2024 at Adobe Max in Miami. And you can access quick actions by clicking on this magic wand icon here on the top right toolbar. And what's new is this is available in Lightroom Mobile as well, and I love it. When Lightroom detects multiple people, as it does here, it'll create these thumbnails for each person. And what's great is before, when you made edits to people using quick actions, it would make the edits to everybody. But now, let's say I go here to person one. So what I can do is go to, say, enhance eyes and maybe enhance clothes. You can see I have this slider here. So if I go back to enhance eyes, I can make the eyes pop even more. Then I can go to person two. Maybe I want to whiten teeth. Again, I've got this slider here. And notice how it's only affecting the person in the middle. I can also smooth the hair and adjust that slider. And then I can move on to person three. Again, I'll go ahead and enhance clothing. Or I can just do an enhanced portrait, which will make adjustments to all of the components here. And you can see that here as I go left and right. It's making edits to the eyes, the skin, the teeth, the clothing. So this is kind of like a nice all-around preset that you can use. And again, if I toggle before and after, you can see the edits that are made to each person individually, which I think is super cool. All right, for the third feature to Lightroom Web, it has to do with the sharing experience in Lightroom. Now, I'm going on the record by saying that the sharing experience in Lightroom just keeps getting better and better. It is so much fun to share photos using Lightroom, and this feature makes it even better. So let's say you have a party or you're going to a wedding. Well, you can go ahead and create an album in your Lightroom library, and you can share that album. But what you can now do is enable an option to let anyone add their photos and contribute to the album. So you can share this album link or the QR code that can get generated with your friends and family, and everyone can just collect the photos from that event, and everyone can see everyone else's photos. It's really cool. So I'm going to show you how that works right now. All right, so this is a small collection of random wedding photos that I found from a stock site online. They're not all the same people, the same weddings, but you get the idea. So you can see I've got this wedding album here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on this button up here called Share Album Menu. And you can see first we have a URL that's generated and it's set to anyone can view. But what I can also do is enable this option. Anyone can add photos. I'm going to click this on. Then I'm going to click on Customize Title and Template. So here you can change the album name if you want. You can also customize what the title is here. And if you want, you can add an author. So here I'm going to say use custom name, and I'm just going to call this Brian. and friends. Cool. Let's go back here. And then under all settings, I'm going to make sure that allow downloads and exports is enabled. And then let's go back here. So now we have this album that's shared, and there are two ways that you can share it. The first, one of my favorite ways, is this icon here, this little QR code icon. When you click on it, you'll get this QR code, which you can download, or you can copy it and paste it and message it to anybody. Or you can just show it if you're viewing it on mobile to your friends and family, and they can just scan it in with their mobile camera app. You can also see over here, anyone can add photos. That's enabled because we just enabled it on this screen. The other thing that you can do is copy this link to your clipboard. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to this incognito window, and I'm just going to paste it in right here. When I do, you'll see there is the album. There's the title with the author. Now, here's the thing. In order to add your own photos to a shared album, you do have to be logged in with an Adobe ID. You can get an Adobe ID for free. Anyone can create their own ID. But once you do, you'll be able to add your own photos if you're given the URL or the QR code to that shared album. And so right off the bat, you can see if I click in here, because I enabled the download option, you can download the image, you can click on info here, get some more information about the image. But if we go to the gallery view, you can see there's this icon here to add photos. So I'm going to go ahead and click on this. I'm going to go to my desktop, and I have a few additional photos here that I'm going to select and drop them right here. Then I'll go ahead and click on upload for photos. I have the option to include location data if the images have them, and then I'll click on upload for photos again. Now that that's done, all you need to do is click on close and refresh. And now what you'll see on each of the thumbnails on the bottom right is a new little piece of information. This is the profile photo of the Adobe ID that contributed that photo. And so this is the profile photo that I use for my primary Adobe account. But as I scroll down, you'll see there's a different profile photo. This is for the account that I'm using here, this test account. You can see the profile photo here. And so I recommend if you have an Adobe ID, just log on at adobe.com with that ID and customize your profile photo, because if you will participate in adding photos to shared albums, it's just nice to have that little extra piece of visual information, and that's pulled by your Adobe profile photo. And what's even cooler is if I go to Lightroom here now, remember this is my personal Lightroom account, and I refresh the album, you'll see all of the additional images, including the profile photos of the people who are adding photos to that album. So if I click here, for example, and I go to info view, you'll see right here also that this photo was added by me. But again, that was my alternate Adobe ID. And what's so cool about this is now I can have kind of a central location, not just me, but everyone who has access to the album, to all of the photos that we all took from the event. Again, whether it's a party, a birthday party, a graduation, or a wedding. So I love how much better the sharing experience in Lightroom gets with each update. All right, so the fourth update to Lightroom Web, this is something that came to Lightroom Desktop only recently, and I love that we have it here. And that is the before and after compare view. So when you open an image up in detail view, you'll notice an icon on the top left over here. This is compare. So if I click on it, it will show me on the left here, the original uncropped photo. And on the right, this is my fully edited photo. So I love being able to see the difference. And you can see just how heavily I cropped the photo. Now, this photo has HDR applied. So if it looks a little bit brighter than normal, it's probably because HDR is not something that I can show with my screen recording software. But you can also click here and change the orientation. So if I want it to be top and bottom, I can do that. But I actually prefer left and right. And so it's one of those kind of small but mighty additions. Like now that we have it, it's one of those things where I don't know how I went without it. And I just love that we're getting that in Lightroom Web. And so for the fifth and final feature, it's in a similar, I would argue actually it's even more powerful. And that's the ability to copy and paste edit settings. So let me show you how that works. All right, so I have two photos, pretty much very similar photos. This one is edited. This one is unedited. So let's say I want to take the edits that I applied to this image and paste it onto this one. What you'll do is similar to Lightroom Desktop, you'll go to the image and you'll open it up in edit mode. Then on the ellipsis over here, when you click on it, you can either just copy all of the standard settings or you can choose which settings to copy. So I'll click here and you can see that there are different selection presets. You can select everything. You could select only things that have been modified, which is generally what I do. Then there's default. Default is the same thing as if you just selected the copy settings or none. In which case with none, you can just select individually which attributes you want to copy. I'm going to go with modified here. I'll go ahead and click on copy. And then I'm going to go to this image here. Again, you can see it has no edits. I'm going to select the ellipsis. And this time I'm going to select paste settings. And there you go. You can see the edits that I applied here under the light panel. My point curve was applied. My adaptive color profile was applied. And so I really like this because let's say you have a treatment that you already made for one image and you want to quickly paste it to a bunch of other similar images. You can now do that right in Lightroom Web. So I hope you see just how powerful Lightroom Web is becoming. It keeps on getting a bunch of new features that Lightroom Desktop and Lightroom Mobile are also getting. And the benefit is here, if you are a subscriber to the Lightroom plan or the Lightroom Mobile plan, you get access to Lightroom Web as part of that. So if you are a Lightroom Mobile only subscriber, for example, and you want just a larger user interface for Lightroom with a bunch of the kind of pro tools that are not necessarily available in Lightroom Mobile, you get it in Lightroom Web. And I do love seeing the team consistently iterate and improve on it. So with that, Lightroom Web is just one of the surfaces, like I mentioned. There's also Lightroom Desktop and Lightroom Mobile. And if you want to learn everything there is to know about it, then please do check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll leave a link to that in the description below. And I mentioned that I have what's new videos for Lightroom Desktop and Mobile. I'll leave them right here. Of course, if you found this video helpful, a thumbs up is greatly appreciated. And please do click on subscribe and the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.